Especially this motherfucker that's calling my phone. She know better. Oh, she back. You're unmuted. Are you there? Are you there?
I'm here.
What's up? How you doing?
Fine.
Okay, what do you want to talk about? You want to talk about the topic?
Yep, the topic.
Okay, go ahead.
I mean, it's hard to really, I mean, it's not really hard to explain, but sometimes when women are in relationships and they haven't had a man in their life, it's kind of hard to, like.
Can you speak up a little louder? I want to make sure everybody hear you. Can you speak a little louder?
I'm not saying it's not hard to.
No, I'm saying, can you turn your volume? I want to make sure they can hear you. I can hear you, but I want to make sure they can hear you.
Okay, my volume's up high. It won't go up no higher.
You got a headset on or something like that?
It's high.
Hey, good morning, Marsha.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah, that's better. Go ahead.
I'm not saying it's hard. I haven't been in a lot of relationships in my life. I've been in relationships, but I hadn't been in a relationship in my life. I'm not really a people person, but when I'm in a relationship, it's kind of hard to, like, I'm not going to say love a person. It's just hard to be that one person for somebody when you really don't have that one person for you. I mean, it ain't hard to explain it, but it's kind of difficult to explain it when you don't have that man figure in your life to show you that a man's supposed to do this for you and a man's supposed to do that for you. You really get dependent. I mean, you really think that you're supposed to be the man yourself. You're supposed to do this yourself. You're supposed to do that yourself. So me, myself, I mean, I have messed up a lot of relationships. I mean,
hold on. Anya, you said it's cutting off and on. Can she not loud and clear, y'all? Can y'all hear anything she's saying? Hold on, because Anya said you cutting off and on. I need to know if she can be heard. Can y'all hear what she's saying? Yeah, Marsha said you're loud and clear. Go ahead, continue.
But sometimes, I mean, I'm not going to say I'm a follower. I mean, I'm not going to say I'm a follower, but I'm most a follower than I'm a leader. If I think if I was a leader, then my relationship probably wouldn't go down as it, like, you know, like it has been going down. Instead of me listening to people and listening to different family members and stuff, people that really don't really care, I mean, you any good in a relationship. But I have messed a lot of relationships up, so I'm not going to say I'm just top one, I'm just A1. I'm full of shit all the time. I ain't in denial. I'm full of shit all the time. But if you got that one person that's willing to help you, fuck with you, do what you need them to do, help you get through whatever you gonna get through, then stick with them, because that one person is you know, really hard to find. I mean, I've been in relationships, but I've been in relationships by a couple of years, and that person really helped me with myself, because everything that I have accomplished really had came from him. And I'm not scared to tell anybody that. I mean, I'm not a bad person. He's not a bad person. It's just that I'm confused sometimes, and then sometimes when you don't have anybody to talk to, or you don't have anybody to listen to you, you listen to the wrong people, and you talk to the wrong people, and it just leads you down the wrong path. But to answer the question, yeah, us women, we do mess up relationships. We do things that we don't want to do. I mean, do things that we really don't supposed to do, that we do, like out of anger. You do this out of anger, you do that. I know out of anger, I do a lot of things. I know I got an anger problem, but out of anger, I do a lot of things, and I say a lot of things. But anybody that knows me really know that I really don't mean what I say. Like, if you make me mad, I might say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. Like for instance, I might say, I'm going to go down to the courthouse, or I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do that. That's just a way for me to, you know, feel better. I'm not going to do that because I'm not trying to hurt nobody. But that's just a way for me, just like a comfort zone. I mean, it's not really right to do, but that's like a little comfort zone for me, and I got to get out of that. That way of threatening people, telling people what I'm gonna do, what I'm gonna do to hurt them, because men do hurt just like women, and I understand that. I mean, I think if I say to myself more, my relationship, my next relationship, whatever, will be a better relationship. Say to myself more, and say to my kids more, and stop listening to other people, what they got to say about him, her, whoever else. But, and then in a relationship, when you break up in a relationship, you really hurt the children too. I mean, sometimes you have to think about the children. I thought about that a couple of nights ago, about what I say in front of the children. You really can't say everything in front of the children, especially when you love them. And you really, when you have older children, it's really hard to be trying to get out of one relationship to another relationship, because those children really don't understand what's going on. Like, for instance, I have a son. I might say something, and then he might look retarded. And he might say something, and I might look at him. But one thing that I learned is that you can't talk down on the other person in front of the child, because the other child feels a less of a person. And you make that child not happy. Just because you're not happy, don't mean the child has to be all happy. So, the best thing you can do is when you hurt, the best thing you can do when you hurt someone is to try to fix it. I mean, ask them, what can you do to fix the problem? Don't argue about it. Ask them, what can you do to fix the problem? I mean, it might not be nothing you can do to fix the problem, but it might be something that you can't do to fix the problem. What can you do to fix the problem? What can I do? I mean, who can I stay away from? How can I make this up to you? How can I fix this problem? Because I know the relationship I was in, he would break his neck for me. He would do anything for me. Whatever I asked him to do, he would do it. That's from buy a phone, from buy clothes, to buy a car. Many people don't buy a car for people, especially put your name on something that you know that they got to pay. Because if I don't pay it, then he has to pay it. Even if we break up, if I don't pay the loan, he has to pay the loan. And then that's a hard pill to swallow. I had to sleep on that. I don't want anyone to feel not wanted. I don't want anyone to feel a lesser person. So to really just break down this live show, Yes, women, we do have problems, and we do hurt men. That's all. Thank you.
Okay. Well, are you there? Are you finna leave, or are you there?
Yeah.
I want to touch on something that you mentioned about a man is like. Can you really express that more and talk about that more? Because I think majority of the women that do have this issue, I think that's what they should you know, pretty much discuss more about. And because there's men out here who didn't have a mother to do that, you know, do right by them or show them enough love to know, show them what a woman is like. But some people can overcome it, some people can't. Do you care to talk about the whole male figure in women's lives situation?
Well, I think every woman needs a male figure in their life. Every woman. It's just the issue that you need that man to show you and tell you what a man's supposed to do. What do you look for in a man? How do you supposed to treat a man? What do you supposed to do for a man? What you don't supposed to do for a man? If you don't have that man in your life to show you, then when you're in a relationship, you really just like I'm the man and a woman. I can do this. I can do that. I don't need no man. And then sometimes when you get to that point that you don't need a man really is no good in the relationship. When you get to the point that you don't need a man, a man is no good in the relationship. I think that a woman, I'm not going to just say that that a woman needs a man in their life when they grow up. But for me, I believe that I needed a man in my life for me, you know, what to expect out of a man. What do I do for a man? What I don't do for a man? I mean, that's just what I think. That's what I would like for my children to you know, grow up as. They're almost grown now, but they always had a man in their life. Even if it wasn't their daddy, it was their stepdaddy. And also a son. I'm not just talking about women. A boy needs a man in their life, too. It's some things that I can't teach my son. And I'm glad his dad's been in his life. Because it's some things that I can't teach him. And it's some things that I can't say to him that his daddy, you know, it's some stuff that I can say to him that he won't listen. But if his daddy said the same thing, he listens to him. Like, I could just say, hey, I'm going to call your dad or whatever. And, you know, he's straightened up. I just thank God I had a man figure since I had my children. But I hadn't had no man figure when I grew up. I think if I had a man figure when I grew up, I think I'd be a better woman. I'm not a bad woman. I have things that I need to work on as to be a woman. But I'm not a bad woman. I just have issues. And I have issues about listening to other people and talking to other people about other people. And I don't even beat the lead conversation. It's just that I just jump into it. And I got that bad about jumping in the conversation, talking about down on a man. And for me, I think that's how my relationship goes bad all the time. I really ain't had a strong relationship. I think only one of my kids' father I really had a strong relationship with. And 9 times out of 10, it's that I'm talking to someone and they saying something and I'm agreeing to it and I'm doing this instead of saying, I don't want to hear it, I don't want to do that. But to narrow it down, yes, us women do need a man figure in our life when we grow up. Yes, we do.
And I want to add to that, because women in this day and age have lost the idea of they don't need protection. I think every woman needs to be protected, because in the real world there's dangers, there's especially if you have children. I think women should understand that men are protectors of not just women, children as well. And this is why a lot of them, I had played a video weeks ago where I was playing an old video from Jason Black where he said that women tend to think that they can leave the house and that's what's left the door open for pedophiles and rapists and things of that nature, because the men that need to protect you, you go have, why is the exclamation mark popping up like that? Okay, yeah, so the women that need the protection run that way and thinking it's all about themselves being the protectors, and that's what happens. And so do you as well. So my thing is that women got to understand that men are the protectors of the world. And this is why, because I do security. What pisses me off is in many jobs I've had, there will be women that look at me crazy like they don't even respect me. But then if somebody was to jump out and take your purse, you're going to look at me and say, hey, you're going to help me? And I'll be looking like, you didn't even acknowledge me speaking to you. You didn't even respect my generosity of just saying hello, my common courtesy of approaching you. Hey, how you doing? You know, letting you know, hey, I'm here to protect you. This is my job. So I don't need you to scream help me when somebody's actually attacking you. I need you to acknowledge me, so when all else does go wrong, you can look for me to say, hey, I recognize this guy is here to protect me because that's his job. So acknowledge me before anything goes wrong. And a lot of times women are looking for the protection when it's too late. What do you think about that?
I think some women look for the protection when it's too late. But then sometimes you have to think about it. Was you really protecting me before it was too late? I mean, sometimes women have, I'm not going to just say me, just women have issues like, I like to talk. I mean, I don't have anybody to talk to, but I like to talk and I like to express myself. I like to, you know, I'm just a talkative person. And if you don't have anybody to talk to, anybody positive to talk to, then yeah, your relationship can go downhill. But I think if I had that one person that I can just talk to, laugh with, chill with, say, hey, this goes on right here. What you think about that? And they tell you the right thing and say, hey, don't fuck with him. You know, don't do this, don't do that. Then I think I'd be all right. If I had that one positive person in my life that would say, hey, that wasn't right. Instead of boosting me on, say, yeah, girl, go on down there, girl. Put him on child support, girl. Go on down there, girl. Do this to him, girl. Do that to him. I think I'll be all right, because I'm not a bad person. I work. I go to school. I just need the right direction. I didn't have the right direction when I grew up. I was adopted. So the parents that I lived with, we went to church more than anything. I mean, I really don't go to church now because I don't even see the issue of going to church. I mean, I'm kind of confused of it. Why would you go to church? I mean, I'm kind of confused.
We don't want to make this a religious thing, because I don't want to open the door for that conversation. So I feel what you're saying, but we don't want to open the door for that, because people might be, you know, I don't want nobody to take offense to it.
Okay. Well, if you have that right person in your life when you're growing up, then when you're grown, I don't think you really have too many relationship issues of breaking a man's heart. But when you don't have that right man or that person, then you tend to break people's hearts. You tend to do things that you really don't want to do, that you do and say. So yes, us women, we hurt men all the time. I'm not in denial. I hurt people all the time. It's nothing you can really, once you hurt someone, it's really nothing you can really do but try to fix the problem. Only thing you can do is say, hey, can the problem be fixed? If the problem can't be fixed, then you just have to move on with the next person and see, can you make it better with the next person? But yes, us women, we do. We do hurt men.
Okay. Well, we finally got one brave soul to come up here. If there's another woman that wants to join in, I can't take multiple phone calls. So, as I see here, we had somebody named Tommy. They left a call, but they haven't came back. Anybody wants to call in, the number's on the screen. And how you call in, you put the show ID code, hit the pound button. It's gonna, you're going to say your name, but you don't have to. It doesn't matter. It's going to bring you in, and I will let you speak. We could do as many calls as we can. If you want to add to what she stated, if you want to add to... tell us a story that you've experienced, because this is basically for women. I will do this now, and I will do this later, because this is a conversation that doesn't get touched a lot. Nobody wants to talk about it. I don't even see women trying to have this discussion with each other on their channels. It's like it doesn't exist. So I'm opening the door where women need to discuss this, because we would discuss what men do. What about what you do? Cause I can open a panel tomorrow, and there's gonna be tons of men come tell you what they've done to women. Trust and believe that. T Money can vouch that. What's up, Wax? I'm pretty sure Wax probably got a story. Most of us don't, but a lot of us do. So at the same time, if anybody wants to join in and add to that, we can. If not, I guess we can just, you know, end it with that. But yeah. What she stated was a lot of truth, and it takes a lot of pride being put to the side and just really say so. Because trust and believe, like I stated, I really didn't have my mom, and it took, you know, I had my mom, but the way my mom should have treated me, it kind of stopped when my little sister was born. It seemed like when my little sister was born, everything went left. And I can understand. I learned as I got older that sometimes that's just how life is. Like, you're not the baby no more, so you get pushed to the back. And that still didn't change the way I was. I still keep my same. I still treat women the same way. I didn't look at women like, oh, you like my mom. I never told any woman in my life, you just like my mom. That's one thing I probably never said. I probably would say, you remind me of this other girl, but I would never say my mom. Cause I wouldn't never wanna hurt nobody feeling saying, oh, you just like my mom. And I never thought that was right. So I can never say I quoted that. But at the same time, I can admit that none of that has changed who I am and how I treat women. So, and I'm not an angel either. I say fucked up shit. I think fucked up shit. And I act. I say fucked up things. I curse. I get mad. I get upset. I yell. I go off. So I'll admit that. But as far as like dogging the women out, I've never done that. Apparently won't have any more calls. Is there anything else you want to speak on the topic before we go? Because I think women might not be up to this topic. What do you think?
I mean, most women, before I go, most women probably are not up to this topic. But like I said, most women need someone to talk to, someone to vent to, somebody positive. It's a lot of women out here that's, you know, not positive. If we just have like a little group that's a positive women and talk about men, positive things about men, I think it'd be more better women for me instead of having negative women talking negative about men. So there's more negative women out here than positive women. So I think if we have like a little group or something, or people talk and vent with women, I think we'll have a better number of women that's positive. Because I think that's what I need in my life. I need someone to say, hey, you know this wasn't right. You know you're supposed to do that. You know you're supposed to do that. I mean, I was brought up, but I wasn't brought up with, you do this for a man. You cook for a man. You do this for a man. I wasn't brought up for that. I was brought up, go home, take a bath, get dressed up. I wasn't brought up with what you're supposed to do for a man. But, yeah, maybe if you have another topic, maybe the women would speak a little better. I don't know.
Yeah, and I'm going to say this before I go. What I think what women do, and men alike, because I'm not going to make this all about women. What I think is that a lot of our experiences make us do the things we do. And I learned this thing over the last, 6 years, right? Is that there's these things called habits, where once you get into the routine of waking up, going to work every day, you don't get out of that routine, because it's like sort of a mandatory thing you do, where you know you're gonna get up, you're gonna put your left shoe on first, you're gonna put your right shoe on second, you're gonna go to the restroom, you're gonna brush your teeth, you're gonna wash your face, you're gonna clean your ears, you're gonna put your deodorant on or whatever. It's like routines. So what happens is, when we're so stuck into these habits, we're so stuck into those habits so long where it's hard to switch. And what I don't like is that you have women say, well, I can't just turn it off that easy. It's not going to happen overnight. And I said to myself, when you have this type of urgency in a relationship and you know that these habits ruin the relationship, you should want to change them. And you should want, like, I have these habits where I switch these habits myself. So, what I'm saying is this, is that there's things you know this man don't like, or there's things you know this woman don't like. So don't do those things. Cut it out. Like, if you could simply cut it out for everyone else that makes you no good, cut it out for the one that does. Cut it out for the one that helps you. Cut it out for the one that actually gives you this quote-unquote amazing feeling that they quote-unquote have, or a good feeling, or if you're in love, or if you're not in love, or if you just like a person a lot, if he's always been there for you. Because the funny thing about it is that there will be situations where you will be friends with a person, then you'll be in a relationship. So in this friendship, you didn't get these habits. But when you fall in love, or if you're in a relationship, you get these habits. that's what's confusing to me, because I always wanted to know, like, well, where was this shit at when I met you and we were just friends for like weeks and months? Like, where was this at? So now when you become one with this man, he gets all these fucking horrible habits, and I think it comes from a lot of experiences. Maybe it's been past relationships where you've been so used to it. It's kind of like, there's women I've met who actually have been abused, who've been physically assaulted by men in their marriages and relationships and ex-boyfriends or baby fathers or whatever. And then what happens is, because I've had this situation where a woman approached me and was like, hit me. And I was like, hit you? And I was like, and then next thing you know, that was the end of the relationship. And it was like, so damn, I was thinking to myself, did she want to get punched? Did she want to get slapped? Did she want the altercation? And it seemed like what happens is she got into this habit where that was normal, and that's what she wanted. And then she realized that's not what she wanted, because it ran me off. So now it's like, wait a minute, that's not what I wanted to happen, because I got so used to that it was okay. It's like the behavior that black people have today, it just seems normal. We walk around with multiple kids, and the guys be sagging their pants. All this shit is just, there's just multiple things that we accept. We think it's okay. We think it's normal. It's not okay. We got to stop pretending that this shit is okay, and it's not. That's what's wrong with us now as black people, that we think everything we do is okay. Yeah, stuck in, a man being stuck in his ways. A lot of people are stuck in their ways. Me, I will put everything in my back pocket, and I will break all the way down before I even try to express myself in a negative manner. Sometimes I'll be thinking, like, I wonder, what if, blah, 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? And then sometimes when things go bad, I reflect and I start thinking, like, man, you know what? What if this was that? And what if she is this way? And then I start, because what I do is I try to block it out. It's kind of like you block it out. Like, I think Kobe Bryant had a thing where he says he'd be on the road and he blocks out the crowd and act like he don't hear the boos. He said the boos sounds like silence to him, but in reality he hears it, but he blocks it out. That's how he's able to focus, because he's able to block out boos going to his ear. So he doesn't pay attention to it. A lot of times I try to not pay attention to certain things, and I just overlook everything. Like, you know what? I want this thing to really work. I'm going to just ignore that. I'm going to just add water under the bridge. Boom. Let it go. Even though deep down I want to go the fuck out. Like, yo, so why are you saying this to me? Why are you bringing this up? Why are you doing it? Then the next thing you know, I just sweep it under the rug. Like, yo, I don't want to make her feel uncomfortable for saying what she said or whatever. You know what I mean? So anyway. Hotel. What's up, y'all, Jay? It was a comment she made. Hold on. It was a comment. Hold on 1 second. Can we have a discussion a little later? I'm at work. Okay. A lot of people that be in the feelings too much. That's what shit happens. Exactly. And then what happens is you realize when it's too late. I'm just saying, I'm 36 years old. I'm at a point now where I don't give a damn if it's a one bedroom shack. If I can sit there and know that it brings me peace, I'm gonna sit in that fucking one room shack, and I'm gonna sit there. And if it brings me peace, that's what's gonna make me happy. I think at all costs, I plan on being happy, no matter what anybody calls themselves trying to do, or whatever they plan on doing, or whatever your intentions is. I just think at this point, I mean, damn, I'm getting old. I'm not young. I wasted my young years fucking around. And I say fucking around, meaning that I'm stuck here. I'm not married. I'm not happy. I'm not with anyone that makes me happy. And I'm at a point where, yo, I'm getting old. I'm getting old. And at this point, like, do I want to go into my 40s doing the same shit with anybody? Like, do I want to go into my 40s knowing that, okay, well, I just want to be with somebody so bad that I'm just going to stay or just be there or do? Nah, that shit is whack to me. And I wouldn't recommend nobody to do that. woman, no. Don't none of y'all. None of y'all.
None of y'all.
Because it's a girl I know that's young. And I was letting her know, like, yo, you don't want to go into your 30s with that same dude. Because then you're going to be 30. And the next thing you know, you're going to be 32. And then 33. And then you're going to be looking at me like I'm looking at. You're going to be looking in the mirror just like I'm looking in the mirror. You're going to be like, damn, 30-something. And I wasted my young years of my wonderful life, of my career, everything. Yeah, I wasted it just trying to make somebody change. You don't want to do that.